It just feels so nice and puffy. It just feels like a pillow and you want to put your head down on it. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, to my little corner of the internet here where we talk about luxury designer handbags. So today I have a very exciting video, hopefully for you guys. Today we're gonna talk about my entire Chanel collection, and that includes my entire Chanel handbag collection as well as jewelry. So I do have collected a couple of things over the years. It is still, I think, a very reasonable amount of Chanel bags. I really like to choose only the ones that really speak to my heart, the ones that make my heart sing. So yeah, let's get right into today's video. Okay, so this beautiful bag is my Chanel Le Boy bag in the new medium size in black lambskin with the antique gold, brush gold hardware. This one was my very first Chanel bag ever. I got this one for my 25th birthday and it was a big, big achievement for me. I mean, everybody always probably will remember the moment they received their first Chanel bag. And so I did pick this beauty. It is lambskin, yes, you have to be very careful. If you would like to see a review on this one, please go to my channel. I've already uploaded a review on my boy bag where I go into all the wear and tear of the bag as well as my own personal opinion. I'm still very much in love with this one. And I also do still have the Chanel Classic Jumbo on my wish list, which is probably the most well-known handbag of all time. At the time I made the decision to get the boy bag, I was debating of actually choosing the Jumbo or choosing this one. And I think I did make the decision to go with this one simply because at the time I think I was looking for something a little bit more edgy. And of course I think that the boy bag fits the bill. That. Okay, so yeah, this was my first ever Chanel bag and yeah, I would never ever let this one go. It's just, I think, so much sentimental value and yeah. Okay, so the bags I'm gonna show you now, they are in no particular order and yeah, so let's get right into this. This is my Chanel Gabrielle bag and I've just got it recently and just before we left for our trip to Japan. And I took it with me and it was a really, really great everyday bag for traveling around Japan. We went from Tokyo to Hiroshima to Kyoto and back to Tokyo and it is just a really comfortable bag because you have the option of carrying this bag V-style and it is really comfortable. If you want to see all the different ways of how you can wear this bag, please go and check out my review video on this beauty. And yeah, so really, really happy with this one and I think I could see myself taking this on many, many more trips in the future. And also I think it's a great everyday bag. So yeah, this is my Chanel Gabrielle and this one is in the old medium size. So they recently introduced a new medium size, which is actually a size in between this one and the small. A lot of people thought that this one is too big for them, the small one is too small. So Chanel recently brought out a new medium size and yeah, there's also a large size, which is a size up from this one, which is, I think, carried by men most of the time because this is a unisex bag. And yeah, I've seen a couple of guys carrying the large version of this one around London. So yeah, I'm pretty much in love with this beauty. The texture of this bag is just absolutely stunning for me. Like, it reminds me of like an old painting. And yeah, really happy that I found this one. Okay, so I also do have the Chanel Gabrielle backpack. I think I'm just a sucker for Chanel Gabrielle lines. So this is the Chanel Gabrielle backpack in the small size. It is just your regular black aged calfskin bag. It does come with all four different types of hardware as the Chanel Gabrielle. As the Chanel Gabrielle does. So also maybe this helps in terms of size comparison. So this is the medium size, now the old medium size of the Chanel Gabrielle, and this is the Chanel small backpack. I did make a review on this one as well. I think I did make a review on any of my Chanel bags. Yes, I think I did. So if you want to get an in-depth review on either of these bags, just go to my channel and check that specific video out. This one I carried as an everyday bag almost throughout the entire last summer and the summer before even. It's just very comfortable. You can just swing it over your shoulder and you're good to go. And I think it is very understated. I mean, from afar, if somebody doesn't know it, maybe, and they don't see the CC, then I think nobody would actually guess that this is a Chanel bag. It just looks like a really nice leather bag. And yeah, I don't know, I've always really loved the look of the aged calfskin. That's why the reissue is also still on my wish list. I just love that look of this wrinkled leather. So it just does get more beautiful with time, I think, and that's a very big bonus, of course, for this beautiful bag. Okay, so next one is my Chanel Camellia Flower Tote. I've just recently uploaded the reveal video of this one, and I found it in Japan in a vintage shop, and I was just looking for a tote for so long, and when I saw this one, I just completely fell head over heels in love with this. I mean, I don't know, I think it holds as much as Never Full GM would hold. But I don't know, it just has something really special. This one is from 1997, so it is a 23-year-old bag. And I think for that age, the bag is still in pretty good condition. So yeah, pretty happy with this one. It does have 4 feet, which protects the cotton material a little bit better if you put your bag down. I mean, I never put my bags down on the ground anywhere. But I mean, even if you just put it on the surface on a table or something and there's something sticky on the table or I don't know what, let's go with that scenario, then of course it's always good to have feet on your bags to protect the material a little bit better. So yeah, this beauty I will be carrying all over the summer, hopefully as soon as the crisis ends, and I can just see myself walking around with this one, just throwing everything in I need, you know, my camera, my gimbal, which is the tripod for my camera, a coat or a jacket, you know, as soon as it gets a little bit warmer, just to have something for the evenings, and then I'm good to go. And hopefully I will be able to record more shopping vlogs in London for you guys very soon. Okay, so another vintage Chanel bag is this little beauty here. I've just recently found this as well and I fell in love with it immediately. I don't know why, it does remind me of a little tiny baby version of the current Bottega Veneta pouch clutch. I just think this is a little bit more feminine and a little bit more timeless, I think, over the years. I mean, this is a Chanel bag as well. This one doesn't scream Chanel. You don't have any CCs, no hardware, nothing. I mean, the only thing that probably gives it away is this beautiful camellia flower at the front. But I think you have to be a Chanel connoisseur to actually guess that this is a Chanel bag. So I really like this understated look of this little beauty, and yeah, pretty happy to carry this one in the summertime, maybe just like when you go out for a nice dinner in a restaurant and you just take this one as a little clutch bag. Okay, and then I have 2 more Chanel classic flat bags, and yeah, I think those two are just really, really special. They are like the jewels in my collection. So yeah, let's start with this one here. This one, I call it, this is my princess bag. I mean, if there's a princess of bags, then it's this one. So this one I picked up, when did I pick it up? I think it was it last summer? No, last spring, but I was already pretty late to the game. So this one came out the year before. And I saw it, I fell in love with it, but I didn't pull the trigger. And then I watched HRH collection, and she does have this one in her collection. And I just got reminded of the bag, and I couldn't stop thinking about her. And I was basically running from shop to shop to shop in London, trying to figure out if they still had one in stock. And I did find it in the new Bond Street store. And yeah, what can I say? I mean, is there a more beautiful bag than this one? This bag is made out of rose sakura satin, and I think it's just phenomenally beautiful in terms of the color combination. So you do have this beautiful pink, baby pink satin material, and then the aged gold hardware, and oh, I mean, yeah. So what I thought is you have to be very careful, especially probably with this material. But I was like, when I got this bag, I was so much in love with it that I just took it out and I just was wearing it everywhere. And yeah, maybe I should have been a little bit more overprotective of this one, because I actually must have put it on a table somewhere, and I'm a bubble tea addict. You have to know that about me. So I put my sugary drink on that table. And yeah, some of the sugary water must have dropped onto the surface, I don't know, and I put my bag down. And usually those things don't happen to me, but yeah, it did. And now I have like a little, circle right here. I did try to capture this in the wear and tear video that I did make about this bag. So go and check that one out. And yeah, nevertheless, I'm still very much in love with it. You can barely see it and it's at the bottom, so I think I can live with it. But yeah, I might have to be a little bit more protective of this one. It just feels so nice and puffy. It just feels like a pillow and you want to put your head down on it. Yeah, I think this one is my all-time favorite handbag. Don't tell any of my other handbags. I don't know, there's just something about it that just speaks to me very, very much. Okay, and then last but not least, I have this beautiful Chanel mini rectangular bag. And this is from the Metidia collection 2019. This one was so hard to find. They were selling out immediately as they hit the stores, and yeah, it took me 7 hours, literally 7 hours, running from one shop to the next, to the next, to the next in London, queuing up in front of the stores, trying to get in on the day that that collection was released to actually get my hands on one. Luckily, I did find the last one that the, what store was it? The Brompton Street store in South Kensington. They still had one, and yeah, then my mission was complete. Yeah, this one's really rare. They go for immensely high prices on the resale market. I did pick this up for £2,800 and they immediately doubled in price. They were sold on Vestiaire Collective on Fashion 5 for £5,600. Even I saw it for $6,000 on Fashion 5. So yeah, I was very happy. My handbag collection would not have been complete if I knew this one existed and I wouldn't have been able to get my hands on it. Yeah, this was a must for me, a very, very big must have, and yeah, just so happy that I have this one in my collection. Yeah, okay, in terms of size comparison, maybe a couple of you are interested in this. So this one is the mini rectangular, and this one is comparable to the medium large classic flat bag. So as you can see, there is quite a big size difference. So yeah, the only big difference that those two bags come with is, even though they're both classic flats, this one of course is a seasonal piece, I mean so is this, but this one still comes with the regular Mona Lisa smile flap pocket at the back, whereas this one, as you can see, has nothing at the back. So yeah, these two are the classic flap bags in my Chanel collection, and like I said before, and you can also go and check my wish list out, I still do want to add the Chanel Jumbo in the just black caviar leather with gold hardware at some point in the future, and also the Chanel reissue. And then I think I'm in flap bag heaven and I have everything that I need. Yeah, okay guys, so these were all the handbags in my collection, so let's move on to the Chanel jewelry part. Okay guys, yeah, for this one I have to come a little bit closer to the camera. So you might have seen this beautiful Chanel bracelet before. I wear it every day, and yeah, I think I'm just a sucker for Chanel and pearls and gold, and yeah. So this one's my absolute favorite from all my Chanel jewelry pieces. And I think it can't get more classic. I can show you how it looks like on. So yeah, this is the bracelet on, and I don't know, I'm just really, really in love with it. I mean, look at that little detail at the bottom as well, the CC sign. It's just absolutely incredible, absolutely beautiful, and yeah, I'm a very big fan of this one. Okay guys, so let's talk about Chanel earrings next. My first ever pair of Chanel earrings was this one. You've probably seen all of my Chanel earrings before because I just wear them in every single video. So this one was my first ever pair of Chanel earrings. I got them in 2016, at the beginning of 2016. Yeah, and I'm not even exaggerating. I did wear these for years, every single day. And yeah, they've been holding up pretty, pretty well. They are really comfortable, I have to say, for their size, and I've never had any problems with them. So yeah, I do know how those have spiked in terms of resale prices. I got them at the time for, I think they were £210, if I'm not mistaken, so it's unbelievable. Like, even I, when I checked out the prices at the time, I was surprised by how well priced they were for Chanel earrings. So I did buy them for only around, like I said, £200, and nowadays they get sold on Fashionphile for $1,495. So, boom! No idea what has happened to the prices. I mean, I get it that they are probably very, very high in demand, but I mean, this is more than a 700% price increase. Yeah, okay, so these ones were my second pair of Chanel earrings, and I think they are just absolutely stunning. I consider those earrings to, I don't know, be the right jewelry for like the grand moments in life. You know, when you go to, I don't know, a really important dinner, or you just celebrate Christmas with your family, or, you know, just like any occasion where you really feel like you want to dress up properly. I think for those occasions, these beautiful earrings are absolutely perfect. Okay, and then the last pair of earrings I have just recently added to my collection. If you haven't seen my Heathrow luxury shopping blog yet, then please go and check that one out. So yeah, this is the last addition to my Chanel jewelry collection. Okay, so here they are. As you can see, they are set with a lot of little crystals on top, and they do have the pearl drop at the bottom. These ones are the first Chanel earrings that I dared to buy that are set with crystals or stones or pearls, something like that, because we all do know that they tend to fall out, and fingers crossed that mine will be okay. I mean, you can always bring them back into Chanel and they will fix them for you. However, of course, your earrings are gone then for a couple of weeks. Yeah, okay guys, so that was it. That was my entire Chanel handbag collection and my entire Chanel jewelry collection as of April 2020 now. Okay guys, so if you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Join our little bag family here. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I see you guys very soon. Bye!